Good morning. Today we are going to study stability of nucleus due to nuclear binding energy. By the end of this topic, you will able to calculate the mass defect and binding energy for the nuclei, explain trends in the relative stability of the nuclei. Let us first understand the structure of atom. As we know, at the center of atom, there are protons and neutrons are present. Protons and neutrons togetherly called nucleus. In nucleus, protons which are present has positively charge and neutrons present without any charge, it has no charge. And electrons which are negatively charged particles revolving around the nucleus in a fixed definite orbit. That all about the structure of atom. See, as we saw earlier, in a small, very small place, so nucleus is extremely small. In such a small place, protons, neutrons are present. Protons, which are positively charged particles, they are present in very small place. And we know same or like charges repelled each other. So they should get repelled. But we can see that majority of the nuclei are stable. Hence, there must be certain factors which affect the nuclear stability or which create the nuclear stability. So let us learn mass defect. Mass defect is the difference between calculated mass and the observed mass of nucleus. Means calculated mass is different than that of the observed mass of the nucleus. And what are the difference we get from the calculated mass and observed mass? It is called the mass defect. Mass defect is denoted by delta M. So let us see how we can calculate the mass of nucleus, how we get the calculated mass of the nucleus. Consider any element having atomic number Z and mass number A. Now we are considering Mp is the mass of proton, Me is the mass of electron and Mn is the mass of neutron. Then let us see how we can calculate the mass of nucleus. So mass, calculated mass of nucleus equals to Z. Z that is equal to number of protons present in the nucleus, that is called the atomic number, into mass of one proton. If you multiply these two factors, that is the atomic number or number of protons with the mass of each proton, mass of one proton, you will get the mass of whole protons which are present in the nucleus. And A minus Z here, A is the atomic mass number and Z is the atomic number. Atomic mass number together, it contains number of protons and number of neutrons. Number of, if you subtracted number of protons from atomic mass number, you will get number of neutrons. If you multiplied this number of neutrons into the mass of neutron, you will get total mass of neutron present in the nucleus. So by this way, this is the total mass of proton and here the total mass of neutron. By addition of total mass of proton and neutron, we will get calculated mass. But when nucleus is formed, observed mass is different than that of the calculated mass. So here, if we calculate the difference of calculated mass and observed mass, we will get the mass defect. This difference between calculated mass and observed mass, that difference is only the mass defect. So mass defect, how we can calculate? Here the Z, which is number of protons, mass of each proton gives total mass of protons which are present in the nucleus. Here A minus Z gives number of neutrons, mass of each neutron, this multiplication factor, this gives mass of all neutrons present in the nucleus. This in total gives calculated mass of the nucleus. And if you subtracted this observed mass of nucleus from this calculated mass, we get whatever the difference we get, that is called the mass defect. Thank you. In our last slideshow, we have studied mass defect. So mass, which is equivalent to mass defect, is converted into energy. Mass defect is the difference of observed mass and calculated mass of the nucleus. Observed mass is always less than that of the calculated mass, and that mass is released in the form of energy. So mass equivalent to mass defect is converted into energy. This energy is given by the Einstein equation. Einstein equation is E equals to mc square. But we have taken here E equals to delta m. Delta m, that is equal to the mass defect into c square, where c is the speed of or velocity of light in a free space. So this energy hold the nucleons of nucleus together. Therefore, this energy is called nuclear binding energy. Hence, nuclear stability is directly proportional to the mass defect. Let us see what is nuclear binding energy. Energy equivalent to mass defect, that amount of energy required to break the nucleus into its isolated nucleons. If we want to separate the protons, neutrons present in the nucleus, so we need to supply the energy that is equivalent to mass defect. This energy is known as nuclear binding energy. This energy is denoted by E and measured in a milli electron volts or joule. This energy can be obtained in AMU, that is the atomic mass unit, by multiplying 931. Therefore, nuclear binding energy can be calculated by the product of mass defect and 931. So, binding energy per nucleon. We have seen nuclear binding energy. Whatever the binding energy per nucleon, per neutron or protons present in the nucleus, that can be calculated by the ratio of total number of binding energy to the total number of nucleons present in the isotope. So, binding energy per nucleon can be calculated by the ratio of total binding energy that can be calculated earlier, that is a mass defect into 931, and the total number of nucleons, that is the total number of protons and neutrons that are present in the nucleus. This ratio gives us binding energy per nucleon. So, delta m into 931, this gives the total binding energy upon A, that is the atomic mass number. Total number of nucleons can be given by atomic mass number. This ratio gives the binding energy per nucleon. See how binding energy relate with the responsible the different whole nucleons, whole different nucleons together. This nuclear stability is proportional to nuclear binding energy. More the binding energy, greater is the nuclear stability. So we plot the binding energy per nucleon in milli electron volt against the mass number for the different nucleon. A curve is obtained. That curve is known as binding energy curve. This curve represents the relative stability of the nuclei with the binding energy. This curve is known as binding energy. If we carefully observe the curve, we found that the average binding energy rises sharply first and then constant for a broad range and then decreases slowly. We also observed that higher the binding energy per nucleon, greater the stability of the nucleus. So we found that stable nuclei have binding energy per nucleon between 8 to 8.8 milli electron volt. So majority of element lies the binding energy between 8 to 8.5 of electron volt. Element having mass number less than 25 have low binding energy per nucleon. They show tendency to nuclear fusion. Means they are not stable. For the element having mass number range of 25 to 65, binding energy per nucleon increases from 7.5 to 8.8. It attains maximum value for iron.